We did a study just looking what kind of indication already registered and also what are in the pipeline of industry and what can we expect. Also we did a study for a review for cost effectiveness, so how cost effective are the CAR T cells in the indications and what have already been published. And what we see is there are now two indications for the pediatric ALL. And when you look at cost effectiveness for the pediatric patient group, the CAR Ts are quite cost effective. When you look at cost per outcome, and outcomes we normally defined in quality adjusted life years in HTA. They are about, I think, 30,000-40,000 euros per patient, and that we called quite cost effective. But when you look at the lymphoma group, it's different. It's the ICER, the cost effectiveness ratio is higher and more wider. So they, I think there's a range between 60,000 and 500,000 euros per patient. So that's the first, can we afford these kinds of therapy? Because when you look at list prices, and we studied list prices in several European countries, and the list prices are about 300,000 to 350,000 euros for one CAR T treatment. So when then you look what is the budget impact for countries, then you see if when you look at the pediatric group, it's doable because there are not that many patients. But for the lymphoma patient group, we have hundreds of patients per country, and then it's quite, you need more budget. And the budget forecast, we did a forecast for 2019 to 2029, so 10 years period. Then I think when you have all patient group, including new indications, for example, Germany have to spend more than 1 billion as a budget for these patients. So that's quite enormous, a lot of money. And also for smaller countries like the Netherlands, we have to spend 150 million, I think, euros. So what you give to one patient group, or to one therapy, you can't give to other patient groups. So we call it in economic terms opportunity costs. What you spend on one patient, you can't give to another patient. And for example, for also multiple myeloma or for leukemia, patients had already other treatments, most often also expensive drugs. We did a study for multiple myeloma, and we have patients who already cost 700,000 euros up to 1 million, and then they need another CAR T therapy of 350,000 euros. One of the problems we also we see is the reimbursement of the therapies in the countries. For example, in Spain and Germany, they have problems with reimbursement. And also in the Netherlands, the CAR T cells for the lymphoma patient group is still not reimbursed. So we still have problems for patients to get access to these treatments. And the main issue is that it's that expensive.